boots.
Power to this area must be partially out.
What are those?
Looks like fighters.
Fighters? I thought this ship didn't have a crew.
Maybe they're automated.
We do not have time for idle speculation. We should proceed. Through the hull breach should we open the door just yet. We must restore the environmental integrity of the hangar bay before we continue.
It looks like there's a computer console on the upper level. Maybe we could restore power there.
Mr. Munro, find a way up there and see what you can do. Until we get to the control room, and I can secure environmental integrity to the entire vessel. Mr. Chell, you may now open the door. You do not mistake one of us for a harvester. Mr. Chell, if you would.
Some serious damage here.
Would have taken quite a bit of damage to this ship.
We must get to the elevator at the end of this hall.
Watch it.
The door's being jammed by something on the other side.
Look like hibernation beds.
I guess there was a crew after all.
A small crew, perhaps.
So where are they?
Harvesters.
I'm sure we'll find out soon. The control room is still one deck above this one. We must get to that elevator. Chang, see if the debris can be blown clear. Chell, find a layout of this deck. Satlos, you and I will attempt to force the jammed door. Munro, Murphy, see if there's an alternate route.
Mm-hmm.
sir. I don't think this door can be opened without moving whatever's blocking it on the other side.
Mr. Chang, what is your assessment?
No good, sir. The molecular density and tensile strength of this material is so high. It looks like there's a maintenance hatch on the other side. But...
hey, Alex found a ventilation shaft.
I can't get much out of this terminal. It's pretty badly damaged.
I can see Munro got around.
Mr. Munro, see what's jamming the door. Deductive reasoning, Anson. Good work.
Definitely a medical lab.
Doesn't look like they even got a chance to use it.
Disaster area.
Maybe the crew made a last stand against the harvesters here.
Let us hope the control room is in better condition.
Looks like they put up a fight.
Not that it did them any good.
That was fast.
I wouldn't be much of a technician if I couldn't open a door.
Shell, seal the door in case there are more scavengers.
Hey, this room looks pretty much untouched.
The harvesters must not have made it this far. The crew must have stopped them.
But it cost them their lives.
These controls appear to be operational.
Looks like we got plenty of time to spare.
Finally, something went as planned.
Environmental integrity has been restored. You may now remove your helmets.
I found something. Looks like an audio log.
Can you play it back?
Yeah, I'm processing it through the translator now.
Help me! They're tearing through the hull!
Our weapons are useless! I can't!
The defense systems are cut off! We're going to be slaughtered!
No!
No, get back! No, no! Somebody help us, please! They're killing us all! Tearing our ship apart! They're unstoppable! Ah!
Oh my God.
Distractions are not going to aid us in achieving our objectives.
That must have been the harvesters.
Mr. Chell, control yourself.
They're gonna tear Voyager apart.
That is precisely what we are here to prevent. However, there has been a setback.
Oh no.
Guess I spoke too soon.
I can aim the gunship and fire it from here. But the loading mechanism seems to be malfunctioning. The charge will have to be loaded manually. Ensign Munro, take a small team to the barrel here and ride the maintenance tram to the end. The plasma focusing router here is misaligned, cutting off power to the firing mechanism. You will have to adjust it. Then, make your way down to the firing chamber. Once there, you have to load the energy round into the firing chamber. When you've loaded the charge, I will then be able to fire the gunship.
All right. Chang, Satlos, you're with me. Chell, you and Telsia stay here.
I thought he was going to pick me.
Hey, don't worry. The ship's deserted. Should be no problem.
I have disabled all the security locks on the lifts and doors in the rest of the vessel. You should have no difficulties proceeding from here.
Doesn't matter. As soon as we're done, we're beaming out of here.
Move it!
What's this?
Don't touch anything.
Uh-oh.
Mr. Munro, what's happening down there? I'm reading a power surge. Mr. Munro, what's your status?
This ship isn't quite as dead as we thought, sir.
There were no indications of such a defense system here. They must be controlled from a different part of the ship.
We'll just have to be careful.
Agreed. Tuvok out.
Maybe they're just maintenance bots. Then we must be an infestation to them.
The only way to move on is down this lift where the robot came from. What'd you pick up?
Some kind of welding tool, but it makes a decent weapon.
I'll say.
Excellent, Munro. You are approaching the barrel. The tram should be nearby. Take it down to the plasma focusing chamber. You must hurry.
careful. That looks like superheated ion gas. Would sear the flesh right off your bones.
Great.
Plasma tubes. We must be getting close to the focusing chamber.
Oh,
gravitic plating in this area mustn't be fully charged.
The door's locked, sir.
Tuvok said he disabled all the security locks. Too bad Chell isn't here.
There's some micro fissures in the door structure. I think I can blow it. Take cover.
Good work, Austin.
I wouldn't be much of a demolitionist if I couldn't blow up a door.
See the harvester ship.
There's another one!
It's almost a Voyager. Help us!
Hurry, Alex.
Get down!
We're not getting through here with those rods down.
Voyager is counting on us. Back to sick bay.
Everyone okay?
Storage chamber. The energy rounds for the weapon should be there.
Here's one. But how do we get it to the firing chamber?
Thank you. is the delay? Why haven't you loaded the charge yet?
I'm working on it, sir.
Highly advisable, Mr. Munro.
Lock and load, Commander.
Acknowledged. I am initiating the firing sequence. Prepare to beam back to Voyager.
Where's everyone else?
We took some damage, had to beam you back separately. Tuvok needs you, come on. The Harvester ship was only disabled, but now they're trying to board us.
That's one tough ship, but at least Voyager's still in one piece.
Chang, Munro, the Harvester's docking tendrils are attempting to breach the hull. Go to the equipment room and restock.
Better stock up. If the Harvesters are anywhere near as tough as their ship, you're going to need some heavy firepower.
Everyone okay?
I'm fine.
As you can see, we took some casualties. Do you require medical attention?
Doctor.
Ensign, I'm quite busy at the moment. If you need medical attention, just come back here.
Harvesters are almost through. Come on!
Munro, the Harvesters are spreading out into the corridors. Stop them at any cost.
Thank you.
do not require medical attention. Your assistance is much appreciated, Ensign.
I'll say. Any later and we might have been a harvester snack.
Munro to bridge. The harvesters have been eliminated.
Good work, Ensign. We'll get cleanup crews down there on the double.
Can't believe the aliens survived the hit from that dreadnought.
It would have been much worse had we not disabled the harvester.
Not that that's going to make anyone around here feel any better.
What do you mean?
Let's just say that, as ship's morale officer, I've noticed people are a little on edge from constantly being on the defensive for so long. I just hope we get out of here soon.
Tuvok, Ensign Munro, report to the conference room in half an hour.
The ICDCM is working. Environmental controls and most critical systems will be online soon. But I don't know if we'll get full power back.
How long before warp drive? I want to get Voyager as far from this death trap as possible.
I might be able to get it up and running, but I can't guarantee its stability with that constant power drain from the Forge's dampening field.
Harry, what about sensors? Can we...
Wait, aren't we...
Go ahead, Ensign. What's on your mind?
Well, aren't we going to counterattack?
What?
I mean, are we just going to sit here and wait for them to attack again, or are we going to strike back?
I don't intend to leave Voyager a sitting duck, Ensign. Maybe you weren't paying attention just now. But we're doing our best to get out of here.
Mr. Munro, you were invited to this conference as a courtesy. The captain has rejected your proposal.
Captain, I'm just saying what everyone is thinking.
All right, Ensign. Just what is everyone thinking?
Well, it's just that people are tired of being on the defensive.
I have to agree. I've talked with some of the crew. Morale is low. They feel vulnerable.
The best defense is often a strong offense.
What are we supposed to do without engines and weapons? Drift over there and use harsh language? That thing's outer defenses could cut Voyager to ribbons.
Not every problem can be solved by force, Ensign. I would have thought you would know that by now.
While we're sitting here licking our wounds, the Forge could send another harvester ship.
All the more reason to get repairs done sooner.
But what if the repairs can't be finished because of that dampening field?
I understand. We're all feeling vulnerable. But I'm not just captain of this ship. I'm the captain of her crew as well. I can't ignore the morale of my people. If they don't get a chance to fight back, they might not have any fight left in them by the time the next harvester comes. And I can't ignore the fate of the other countless victims this Forge has taken, and the ones it's yet to take. We've been fighting so hard for our own survival, we've almost forgotten our responsibility to the others trapped here. If we have a chance to stop this madness once and for all, we must take it. However, Voyager is in no shape to challenge the Forge. Mr. Munro, I take it you have a plan in mind.
Yes, I do. Trojan Horse.
The harvester ship.
Of course!
I can take a small team of my best people. We use the harvester to enter the Forge and lower its defenses so you can send reinforcements and shuttles. If we can shut down the dampening field, Voyager and the other ships should be able to escape.
We don't have any idea what kind of internal defenses that thing has.
At the very least, we can buy Voyager some time.
All right. Tuvok, Chakotay, Munro, let's put together a plan. It's time we brought the fight to our captors.
Once the dampening field generator is down, we will evacuate the Forge and return to Voyager via the shuttlecrafts.
Crewman Jaworski, yes.
Sir, how are we going to get the harvester back to the Forge? We don't know how to operate it, do we?
A science team has examined the harvester ship and discovered an automatic recall system. The ship is programmed to return to the Forge on its own.
Your team leader, Ensign Munro, will now brief you on your specific mission objectives.
The first team is going to be a small group, just myself, Telsia, Beesman, and Chell. We will board the harvester and initiate the auto-return sequence. We believe the harvester will return to this area of the Forge, a docking ring of some sort. Still under construction, apparently. Our scans indicate that the external defense's power grid is located somewhere in this area. Once we shut it down, we'll call for the reinforcements. That's where the rest of you come in. Once we rendezvous, we will spread out and proceed down this main shaft. We'll try to locate the generator for the dampening field and destroy it. allowing Voyager to escape. Any questions? Liz?
What kind of resistance are we going to run into?
Honestly, we don't know. We presume there'll be more harvesters over there, and who knows what else. We don't know anything about this forge, and who's operating it. But I expect pretty heavy resistance. Look, I know some of you must be scared. I know I am. But the hazard team was created and trained for exactly this kind of dangerous assignment. We can beat this thing.
This crew has repeatedly surprised and impressed me over these past several years. Starfleet, Maquis, and others. We've all come together and performed beyond the expectations of even the finest starship crew. I know you can do this. We will shut down this death trap.
All right. Let's suit up and get going. My team, meet by the harvester docking tendril in 1/2 hour. Dismissed. Come to wish me luck, Tuvok?
Vulcans do not believe in luck, Mr. Munro. However, your success is crucial. And while I believe you will prevail, I hope that your mission does not encounter undue adversity.
Thanks, Tuvok.
We will join you as soon as your team deactivates the outer defenses.